Hi, it's Stacy here, and in this video I will show you how to use the recent posts block of Getwit. You can often see a list of recent posts at the bottom of a blog post or in a sidebar when recent posts come as a part of your theme or when they are added with a specialized plugin. However, the recent posts block from Getwit allows you to add a dynamically updated list of recent posts into the body of any page or post. In order to be able to use this block and many others, make sure that the latest version of Getwit is installed and activated on your website. The newer the better. To add a block, open a page or a post where you want to see it. Then click on the plus icon to see the full list of available blocks. Find and click on Recent Posts in the Getwit Block section. If the full and wide width layouts are available in your theme, you will be able to switch between them for this block in the top bar. Full width means that the block's width will always be stretched to full screen no matter how big your visitor's device is, while the wide width layout will limit the width of the block to a certain number of pixels on any device size. The setting next to it is the display view of our posts. It can either be a list or a grid. Note that with the grid layout, we can also choose the number of columns. The same layout setting comes first in the right-hand menu. Below that are toggles for standard parts of a post. These are title, featured image, excerpt, publishing date, categories, and comments. When you enable this for display, some new settings will come up. For example, after enabling the title, we can choose a tag for it. These are only the names of HTML tags that should be available in every theme. However, each theme has its unique styles for each of the tags. So whatever tag you choose for your title, the style will depend on your theme as Getwit is trying to blend in the design with the rest of your website. You may see that heading 1 is missing. It is because Google prefers this tag to appear on any page only once, and most likely this tag is already being used by the website title. In order to avoid overloading the page with images of a bigger size than needed, we can limit the size of the loaded featured images. For example, if you know that these images will not be wider than 300 pixels on most device sizes, then it would save you some loading time if you choose to display only 300 pixel wide images to begin with. You can also choose to crop the images if the thumbnails look better like that. After that, we can decide how long the excerpts should be. They are measured in the number of words. Any text past this number will be available for reading only on the page of the post. By default, all these posts are listed from the newest published to the oldest ones, but you can also reverse this order or reorder them by alphabet. Below, we can also choose to display all posts or only the posts from a specific category. And number of items is the number of posts that are displayed in this list. The last setting is in the Advanced tab, and it is where you can add your custom CSS class if you want to customize the design of this block even more. That was everything about this block. Let us know in the comments if you have any more questions or what you think about this block. Like the video so that we know that you liked it, and subscribe to the channel to stay up to date with our WordPress tutorials. Thank you for watching and have a great one!